Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. You shall name him Jesus. You will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. Of his kingdom there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who is called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So I don't know if you remember or not, but this is the feast day that I shared with you a song that I wrote about our Blessed Mother. So that's what I'm going to do this year. And so please do not clap. I know that's a temptation for some people to clap, but let this be a prayer and meditation for us today on this feast of her Immaculate Conception. So it's very cool that we get to celebrate her Immaculate Conception during the Advent season as we prepare for her giving birth to her son, Messiah. But then I think it causes some confusion because we're not talking about Jesus being immaculate conceived, even though he was. Very sure he was immaculately conceived, but Mary was immaculately conceived. We'll celebrate her birth 9 months from now on September 8th. Is the birth of Mary we celebrate. So she's vital. I hope that y'all can gather my own personal devotion to her. And vital to our life as living well on our Christian life. As the daughter of the Father, as the mother of Jesus, the mother of God, and the spouse of the Holy Spirit, we have to know her if we want to try to love Jesus the best that we can. She's the number one person to lead us to Jesus. And so all of you that today celebrate your consecration, if you're here, that you did that this past 33 days, this is a very special day for you for the rest of your life, that you've given your heart, your will, your everything to Our Lady to be presented to her Son. It's a consecration to Jesus, but through her hands, through her perfect hands.